Well, hello there, Tracy Noriega, paying it forward to you here on Power to the Peeps. And PEEPS stands for Positive, Extraordinary, Everyday People Stories. And I'm really, really excited about Edith B. Kiss is here with me. We met years ago in, first an entrepreneur group and then a self-development course with the great guy in Elon Ferdman. Of Satori Prime. And that's where I really got to know you. And you have been just manifesting all the things that you talked about when we met, your dreams of being in London, of starting your personal practice, your healing practice. And she's here with me today because she is one of the contributing authors to an Amazon bestseller, One Habit for Entrepreneurial Success. 300 life-changing habits to turbocharge your business. And she contributed chapter 25, Fill the Gap. And from what she was explaining to me, it's asking all these entrepreneurs one habit to get rid of and then one habit that you implement. So would you like to explain, Edith, what your contribution was in this book?
Yeah. Hi, Tracy. Thank you for having me here. So yeah, it was amazing experience to be in this book. And so I had my book ideas, but I never started to write a book. And then when this came up, I was like, wow, I can get some of my message out there, you know. So the first is my habit is like filling the gap. Is about how I go from A to B, how I reach actually my dreams. And because I'm a dreamer, I always dreaming about big things. I love traveling. I love experiencing things in life. So I always put out some goals and then I just go for them. So filling the gap for me is like knowing where I want to go and then to fill out the gap by finding what I need to do to get there. So I actually making massive actions to get there. So learning new language or having a new skill or getting the experience to reach that goal together and or networking and reaching out to people. So when I have a dream, I'm not just dreaming and dreaming and dreaming in the bed, but I look for the solutions because I know that the solutions are out there. You find solutions for everything that is everything is possible and everything is out there. So I came from a communist country, you know, and then we had the life when we were kind of limited in many things. But I always believe that even I am from a country like Hungary, like communist country, I can still travel to the Caribbean, work on a cruise ship, or I can go to Mexico for an internship. Mm-hmm. And then I just was filling the gaps to get there by learning Spanish, by getting contact with people, and also to get the experience to get there. And then I reached those goals and it was amazing experience and it's actually added to my life by this experience and knowing even more people and getting connected more. So that's what I love about filling the gap. And my unhabit is thinking negative thoughts. So stop thinking negative thoughts. That's my unhabit. Because what you think and what you say and what you do, that's what you are actually, because your thoughts creating vibration, frequency, mm-hmm. in your body, and then the negative thoughts, the negative words have negative energy, and they are blocking your chakras, and how your everything is energy, so your body is also from energies, and what you can see in your body is just the part which is vibrating on the frequency, which is visible for your naked eye, but there are parts of your body that you cannot see, the energy parts, you know, mm-hmm. and then those are connected with the physical parts through the glands. Every chakra is aligned with your glands. And then by thinking negative thoughts, you're actually blocking the chakras and then you're actually negatively affecting the hormone production of your glands, which is actually affecting your well-being. So that is so important to be conscious about what we think or what we say and take the time to be conscious, to be more patient, you know, with each other and with ourselves. And then when we react to our environment or certain situation, that's when we actually start to have these negative emotions through these reactions. And then that's which is causing these blockages or emotional traumas. And then all of these is going to stay in your body, because to release them is really hard. It's really, it's not easy. You need to get into a certain state with your brain, with your body to actually be able to release it. And as a karma healer, I learned techniques from Kashmiri karma gurus in India that actually you can do this by the help of samadhi meditation and the source memory healing. So the samadhi meditation is amazing tool, because it brings your brain into delta brain waves and also activating your pineal gland. And by activating your pineal gland, your body and your brain start to produce necessary hormones. And that's actually creating a brand new mindset for you, because you're going to have more melatonin, serotonin, oxytocin. So you're going to feel more loving, more balanced, more less stressed. And it's even you start to produce growth hormones, so your body is going to look nicer. So by this meditation, the samadhi meditation is going to help you to actually improve your life. And by that, doing that meditation, you're going to have less negative thoughts because of those hormones that you produce. Right. And that's going to support you actually not thinking negatively. And then you can get into the next step. When your brain is in delta brainwave, you can do the source memory healing, when you're actually communicating with your unconscious mind and you release all of these illnesses or your emotional traumas from your unconscious mind, which is actually causing the illnesses that you experience. Okay.
Like all right, way. We've gone way. Yeah, let's get some people caught up. Let's get some people caught up here, as we went from your book, which is awesome, because you can hear. I mean, I totally hear it. It's all about energy. But I know you didn't start out as an energy healer. I mean, now you are, and wow, you just went right into it of all these things that you're doing. Because I hear a conglomeration. But let's remember, a lot of listeners out there are like, there's so many people that have heard Reiki and don't even really know what it is.
Yeah. Right?
I mean, they have this concept just because it's been heard about more often, but they still don't know. I mean, even Ruben asked me, he's all, is that that one where they're putting their hands about, you know,
yes.
You know,
they know about it.
Yeah. Yeah. So let's just back up a little. So you have used these two techniques, your habit of your positive habit of filling in the gap by just being that of which you want to be, but also just feeling those feelings, I hear you saying, and then just taking the actions in that direction. So that's your one positive habit. And then the habit that you dropped was the negative thinking that I think all of us, myself included, can definitely improve upon. And you gave all the reasons why, because those negative thoughts, I mean, all of it is energy. I mean, I have that teaching a lot in my ARC method, and even in the book I'm writing to for little kiddos about, yeah, everything's energy. So we're all energy. We're always attracting that. As I tell my nephew all the time, what you give is what you get. So be careful about what you're giving. But I know when I met you too, you had been doing energy work, but you hadn't made it, your vision was to make it an actual practice.
Yeah.
So how did you go from, you know, just getting into energy work and then to here? Yeah, let's
so
help.
Actually, when I started Reiki, it was like 16 years ago. I had some panic issues, and then I was looking for some treatment, some healings, but I didn't want to, you know, go to the doctor and take some pills, you know. So, and then the friend of my mom, she knew someone, a Reiki master nearby. So I started to go to her for healings. And then because I was very interested, I started to do also the sessions to learn it. And then I became a Reiki one practitioner first, which is actually the one who's putting on the hands on the patient. So the Reiki one practitioner is that who's actually had to touch the patient. And then a year later, I did the Reiki two, and then that's the person who's hovering the hand above the other people, because they are already, the Reiki 2 practitioner can already send energy in distance as well, around the world, wherever you want. So they have the knowledge and they have the tools, the codes, what they use to send the healing distantly. And then, meanwhile, I was becoming a petroleum engineer. I was already working as a petroleum engineer in oil industry. I really liked it. I was passionate about it. I enjoyed it. And then But parallel, this was my kind of my hobby. And then every weekend when I had time or whenever I felt like I want some retreat, you know, I went to my Reiki Master for like extra sense retreat, or we did family constellation therapies for each other, helping out. So that was really fun being in that spiritual environment. And I was always thinking about it, that that's my sanctuary, that's my hobby, you know, and besides my engineering thing. But then time was passing by, and then I felt that I got overwhelmed from the job, and I had already the two children, so I wanted to spend more time with them. So I was looking for some solution to get out of this rat race from the 9 to 5, you know, because I felt like something is wrong. Like I'm getting home at 6 p.m. I hardly see my kids, you know, and whatever. So I felt something is off. And I also was overweight at time, like with 20 kilos, like 40 pounds. And I wasn't eating healthy. I started some exercises, but it did not work, you know, and then I was always stressful from the job. So eventually I decided to move with my whole family to New Zealand, and because I heard that it's a work-life balance and it's cool place, and yeah, and then I just felt like, let's try. And then I quit my job, like in the middle of the oil industry misery, when everybody was looking for a work, I just quit it. And then and I actually arranged to go to New Zealand. We kept packed up everything. And then before I left, I did the Reiki Master course. So I said, okay, let's do this, because I don't know when I'm coming back. And then I want to finish up all my Reiki studies with the same teacher. So I went to New Zealand as a Reiki Master. So there we went into a beautiful house next to the beach. And then we had an amazing 7 months there. I was homeschooling my kids. I was learning about them a lot. Finally, I spent enough time with them, and I was continually healing myself. Yeah. That means like first every day, then sometimes every second day, but I was continually in the very high energies of the master energies. And after like 6-7 months, we find out that we can't really stay there because we couldn't find jobs we wanted, or what was allowed to us to look for, because we were in the immigration process.
Right, in a visa.
So yeah, and then actually we decided, okay, then let's go home. But then when I was coming home, before I was coming home, I went through again a health-related thing. And then when I was coming out of it, I felt like I got reprogrammed, which means that actually I felt like a programming came to me that I can't eat certain things. So I was eating white flour, processed sugar, all the dairy products, and alcohol in like 1 day.
Oh,
like,
wow.
It was really so strong. I went to the kitchen and I knew I can't eat that, I can't eat that, I can't eat that. And then the funny thing was that the alcohol came just later, because it wasn't around, you know, I didn't see. So a couple of days later, I came to the kitchen, I see the bottle of wine, and then I was like, oh my God, this is on the list. So I knew in that point I can't drink any more alcohol in my life. So I felt it like a reprogramming. It doesn't, I don't need to pay attention, or and then I don't need to, what can I say, force myself not to eat those things, because I just
feel
that it's not a food for myself. It's like, you know, when you see dog food and it smells good, but you know you're not gonna eat it because it's for the dogs. But what I'm saying is that if I look at like white flour or sugary things or you know, dairy products, I know it's not for me.
Well, that's your energy work, I would think, too, because you're getting so attuned with yourself. I mean, a lot of people are, you know, that I meet all the time, and until they go to a doctor to take one of those little skin tests, and then they're like, oh, I've been eating all these things that are, you know, bad for me. But when you're not in tune with it, right, and you're not getting that vibration. So where is home for you? Because you mentioned that, but you haven't said where would be home, because you've been so much all over the world, even since I've known you.
So it's
now it's UK, now it's London.
Yeah, I just wanted to finish up with this food thing. Okay, so we went home from New Zealand to Hungary that time.
So that's where
to Hungary. And then what happened, I lost 20 kilos in 10 months. So because of this dietary change, you know, so I went back to 18 years old body, which was actually also giving me a different mindset, you know, a different way of feeling about myself. My confidence grew a lot since. And so, Yeah, because I know it, my confidence was probably very, very low with the extra kilos, you know. So I felt like a rebirth, and then I felt very good. And then also I didn't go back to the rat race, because when I came back to Hungary, there was no position for me. So I was becoming a contractor. I made my company. So that's why my entrepreneur startup started, you know.
Right.
And then it was so great that I went to the office like two times a week. I was able to play tennis in the morning when others were sitting in the office, you know. I was so free. I was the one who was picking up the school, the kids from school. I spent a lot of time with them. So everything I imagined I want to be in my life, it was happening, you know. So having the time, having the money, having the freedom, and still doing engineering stuff was still nice for me. I still liked it, you know, in that time. But I already, that was the year when I started with the Satori Prime. You remember, in 2017.
Yeah. 2 years,
because I already felt like something off. So even though I'm still doing the engineering work and I do it the way I want to do it, I still felt like my energy and my I don't know, like my awakening is coming, you know, and then I needed some pass, you know, I needed someone to show me if I'm going to the right direction. Right. Like, and that was the Satori Prime brothers who actually helped me with that. And then I was with them for like a year, actually.
We were in that program. So then I remember then, because you had said, I really want to be in my practice full time. I really want to make this happen. But now I see, because when I knew you then, you were just Reiki Master. Not that that's not some thing, but now you have all these extra. So I would to let people know what it is you do and how you've used these other ones to enhance your offerings and your transformation, that you help people to do these same exact things, because I want people to know that that's what you facilitate for them.
Yeah, so what happened is that I get introduced to karma healing like a couple of months later, accidentally, because I was just invited to translate. And then when I sat through the first session there, and I mean the lessons, and then I was doing the samadhi meditation, I felt so much aligned with all the learnings, you know. And then I suddenly started to change the world around me, like day by day I started to get messages and breadcrumbs from the universe, like what to pick up, what to go for, you know. And that in those next couple of weeks I started to have really strong messages where to go, what to do. For example, for London, I was coming to London to an SFM meeting in that February, and I've been in London many times before as well, in course other engineering stuff or courses or visiting. But that moment when I was, that was already after the samadhi meditation, I was sitting in the taxi from the airport to the city, and suddenly I started to cry in the taxi, and a message came to me, says home. And I was like, what the heck is going on? Why am I crying in a taxi? The chauffeur is driving. I had no clue what was going on. I had no clue. And then home, I was like, I don't like London, you know, like and it's so many people. And then I was on the training, I mean, on the, it was a conference, SFM conference. And then I stayed another week visiting some friends and staying over. And then I went back. I knew I was already in the process of divorce. So my husband already knew I want to leave him. So I went back home, and then it was still a couple of months passed by, like when I really acknowledged, yes, I have to go to London, because there was so many other information came to me, like I have to come to London, I need to establish my healing service in London, and I need to heal people in London. So that was like a message.
Very
that
much,
I need to come. And then later, actually, I found out that there were people came into my life in London who I had karmas from previous lives. And that why it was happening, you know, the all things was happening because I had to resolve karma with these people from previous lives. And then actually I ended up having clients, they become my clients, and then I was solving their emotional traumas. I was solving their addictions, you know, I was solving their all kinds of issues, and then they started to have a much better, more successful life. You know, they got more focused, they got more empowered, they got more released, you know, and then they actually attracting positive things into their life. And then to see that, I was so happy about it. And then And that's how I created my packages, because these clients were like one-on-one clients, you know, VIP clients. I spent a lot of time with them, many times in their homes, you know, having several sessions. But now, because of the COVID, we can't go to visit each other. So I do everything online. So I actually established my whole program that I can do it through Zoom, you know, or through Messenger video and through phone. So I can do all of these healing sessions online. And I had also a couple of clients from the US as well, doing all my transformation plans. And then they also changed their life a lot. And then they are more stable in themselves, you know, more feeling loved and more encouraged to do what they want to do, because it's many times is the confidence is an issue, the fear is an issue, the feeling unsupported or feeling because of emotional traumas, because in their childhood they were unsupported, or in their childhood they got into traumas where they lost someone or lost something or experienced loneliness, and then this is just piling up and then coming all the time back and back, like triggers, you know, that you're getting triggers until you don't release them. And eventually they became illnesses, mental or physical illnesses. And that's why it's better to release them as early as possible until they become illnesses. And then, so this
Well, that's the big thing is awareness, right? Because if you're not even aware of this, I mean, a lot of people don't think, I mean, they know there's stuff from their past, but you know, they want to believe, well, I pushed that down or I dealt with that, and don't realize that it's still coming up, that there's those triggers, and how you talked about the body, you know, and I speak about that too with the, your body stores everything. So like listening to your body and having body awareness, like makes you aware, hey, there's something going on, right? For you to be able to get it.
And then, you know, you also keeping things, it's not just what you experienced and what you went through this lifetime. You also keeping things from your ancestors in your DNA, in your belief.
Yeah, ancestral, yeah.
The belief system is also from your heritage, like from parents or from grandparents. And they are not in the unconscious, actually, they are in the subconscious. So when we talk about mind, the mind is, many people think it's your brain, but it's a different thing. So the mind is actually in your whole body. And the mind has like three parts. Like you have the conscious mind, what you use when you need to analyze things, when you need to set goals or write your plans. That's when you use your conscious mind. And then you have the subconscious, which is like 80-90%, and is actually holding your fears, your habits, your belief systems, and your memories. And then what is in the subconscious mind can be actually replaced or rewrite by repetition and by being mindful. So that's the good thing about that. It might you are fearful, but you can get rid of your fears if you are conscious and you repeatedly experiencing this or going into it, you know, and then you can deal with that. Or your habits, like you can change your habits also by repetition, by doing it for 90 days and then it's become your habit. And then also with the belief system, what you actually experience through your parents or grandparents, you can get rid of those as well by repetition. But the unconscious mind is a tricky one. The unconscious mind, which is like 1-2%, that's holding the emotional traumas, the grief, the sorrow, the guilt and shame. These are the ones it's really hard to get rid of. That's when you need to.
But you know, in your practice, and I see that too, because I speak about that, there's so many different breathing techniques, and that's one of the best ways to calm yourself when you feel yourself in a reactive mode, when you feel all these emotions and these, you know, like, I don't know what I'm feeling right now. I'm feeling very, you know, people will, you know, I don't know where this, like you were saying, anxiety or a panic attack, etc. So I'd like people to know, because we're coming up on the half hour, what you're, you know, they're going to go to your site. And I love your introduction webinar, speaking about the chakras, speaking about all of this with the subconscious mind. Yeah. Help people understand the chakras and what they are a part of and tuned to. But what would you like to let people know? Like, who is this for, these healings? And what kind of, you know, length of time? People are always going to ask about the length of time. How long does this take? And with it being done remotely, which beautiful that it's energy and so it goes everywhere.
Yeah, I have different packages, actually. I have a short package, which I call like 2 weeks transformation plan. which I include 8 sessions. It can be done 2 weeks or 3 weeks. It depends on how much time the client has. But I included in there also the Reiki healings, also life coaching sessions, meditation sessions, because I don't not just do samadhi meditation, but I do the ancestral cleaning, the defect meditation, and also the source memory healing. So there is like 2 sessions of karma healing and 2 meditation, life coaching, and Reiki. So that package is actually 2-3 weeks time, and it's very much recommended, and this already brings a lot of changes in the people's lives. So already clear their chakras, their aura, you know, they already get into the karma vortex by practicing the meditation and getting aligned and then activating the pineal gland. So they already start to attract positive changes in their lives and then see their purpose, see what where they need to go, which direction, what to get rid of, how to actually build their life again, build up their new life. Because what is happening in Zeus memory healing is that we rewrite the past. And that's how you create your brand new future. So you can actually see during the source memory healing, at the end, we ask the Supreme Pure Consciousness to show how everything changed in the Akashic Records. So we rewrite the memories. Yeah. This is so amazing. When I'm doing karma healing on myself, because whenever I feel some physical issues on me, I immediately go into samadhi and then I go into karma healing and then I try to find those memories. And I mean, my unconscious mind is finding those memories and then I release. Then sometimes I'm getting into past lives, you know, and it's so much fun actually to see where is that fear was coming from. For example, I had a fear that was coming from when in my past life I was a baby boy, got lost in the forest. And that and then that time, so I had to heal that trauma from that baby boy who I was in the past life, that fear not to experience fear now, or the worries or whatever. So what it's for who is this is, I would say everyone who's finally reaching to the point feeling uncomfortable about the mental or physical situation, you know, because you have a mental or physical issue. And then for a while, of course, you're visiting doctors, you're trying these remedies or that remedies. But when you get to the point that, okay, I need help because I can't bear it anymore, then those people who's turning to me, you know, because they couldn't find help, no, but never other places, you know. So they came to me and say, okay, now I'm in a deep place and please help me, get me out of there. I have this issue or that issue, or I need to go in 4 weeks to the surgery and I don't want, or whatever. Then they came to me and then they come to me and then I do this process with them and they can start a new life. They can rebuild themselves up again. And I also give guidance, you know, what to change in their life, you know, because if you don't change anything, I do the healings, but if you don't change anything, it's not going to work, you know, especially for the Reiki. So many people is knowing only the Reiki, so they kind of feel a bit afraid of the Sekhem or the karma, and then they say, okay, just do some Reiki, you know, and then I do the Reiki with them, but I say that, okay, this you're going to feel maybe good for a couple of months or weeks, months, but if you don't change what caused this issue in your life, you're not going to you're going to block everything back. Right. You're going to block your chakras back again. Because that relationship which caused this, you're going to stay in that relationship, is going to cause you sickness again. Or that work, what you do. So you either need to go away from that work or that relationship, or change your mindset.
Change your mindset, right.
And then look at it with a different perspective. Mm-hmm. So for example, work which was frustrating you and you created these reactions for towards that work, then you can change your mindset and say, okay, I'm grateful to have this job because other people are out of work. And you go every morning to work like, I'm so grateful to have this job, and then I'm going to do my best because I need that money. So that's a different mindset to go there than saying that, oh, I have to go again to work. So,
right. If you look at it from the service part and the gratitude and such, then because it goes back to, if you keep doing what you're doing, you're going to keep getting what you got. So, and even if you can't change your external circumstances, I think the biggest thing is it's really the inner work and changing your mindset. Oh, you know what? Hold on, my little plug here.
But you know, sometimes people is having issues.
Sometimes the light switch gets turned off, and I realize it's so. Yeah, So I want, yeah, to let people know that your work can be done remotely because it is energy work and it's transmissions. And I think the biggest thing too that I, you know, well, I think that all healers and people out there should know and like realize is that when you go to a healer, the healer's facilitating the healer. They're not actually the person doing the healing. And you, yes, you said that too, because you're like, I can do this work on you. I can help you with this much. But if you don't continue the work, if you don't change the habits, if you don't change the mindset and the energy from which you're working, then there's really not going to be a change.
Yeah. So we are, healers are vessels of the universal energy. So I invoke the energy and I project. So we just learned, we just trained how to invoke and what tools to use to project. Or in the other case, at the karma healing, we were just trained how to actually bring you into that phase, into the where you can actually communicate with your unconscious mind. Or we learned how to say different releasing prayers, you know, that's what a healer knows or trained for, you know. But yes, definitely the healing is going in the person or by the person. Yes.
Mm-hmm. Yes. And it, and again, it's all our responsibility.
Yes.
Right. It comes back to us being responsible, because even me working in the hospital, I'll see people who come in, we fix them up, we open up their, you know, arteries, their veins, put some stents in, and then they continue to eat crap, not not exercise, not, you know, take what meds they should be taking, or, you know, doing what they, you know, should be doing. And then they're back again. And it's like, wow. Right.
No, so the energy work is good in this case, that it's helping you to support the change, you know? So it's actually helping you to change your mindset. So it's not requires that much work from the client than if they don't get the energies, you know. So when you get the energies, you get into a state like you can actually easier change your mindset. As I said, with the hormonal productions, you know, with the oxytocin,
right, that also helps.
It's gonna help you to actually think differently, or
All right. Well, that is beautiful. And people, again, I know there's so many people who are experiencing anxiety and everything that's going on. And I'm sorry to hear you guys in the UK are having this second wave of a lockdown going on. Mm-hmm. I know I've been talking to friends of mine who are out there, and that just sense of, you know, it's anxiety, and people are feeling frustrated and stuck and whatnot. And what can they do? So, you know, I encourage people to, this is the time for doing that inner work. You know, yes, we're almost exactly. All of us being given that time out of, well, what do I do now? Well, what do you need to do in here? So
yeah, it's the time to raise your vibration, and that's how you can do that. Yeah.
Yeah. For all of us, so that when, you know, we can get over this and come out on a higher vibration and and I think that's the big thing. We all have the responsibility to heal ourselves first. And that's what I hear that you did too, before you became a healer to other people, is really doing that inner work for yourself. That way you also have that understanding and that compassion and that, you know, relatability to say, I know where you've been. I've been there too. And these are some of the things you can help to facilitate those changes. And that's just it. People have to really want that change, right?
Yeah. Yes,
and exactly. It's scary. It can be scary. Yeah.
Sometimes, you know, some people want good to other people. And for example, one of my clients was referring me to someone else who had issues, but that person wasn't ready. She said, right. No, I'm don't want to do Reiki, or I don't want to do energy work. I take the pills, you know, so we can't help them then.
No. So beautiful. Everybody, again, the Amazon bestseller contributing author, congratulations on that.
Thank
that
you.
Had to feel good to be asked to contribute to that book.
Yeah, it's an amazing experience. Amazing. Yeah. And new people, you know, all of those contributors are such a great people, and just getting into that vibe, it was amazing.
Yeah, and just getting your word out there and your one habit. That's
and, you know,
awesome,
it attracted the energies actually that another friend offered me to be in her book. Like 2 weeks later, I submitted my chapters, you know, another friend came to me like, do you want to be in my book? And then that's how I got into my second book.
Well, congratulations. That's awesome. So everyone, yeah, please check that book out. It's on Amazon. It's one of the bestsellers right now. And you see her website right there. She does work yes, she's in UK, but this is the great thing about having the digital and doing energy work, that it doesn't matter where you are. It's all about intention, and you can send that energy there. And it's awesome. I've had actually a friend, Isabella, you know, Isabella, we are kind of accountability partners in life now. And we do some work together. And she said, let's just sit there. And we were just transmitting to each other. Like, I gave her some energy for 5 minutes and vice versa. And it was just so like, whoa, you know, vibrating at such a high level. So everyone, I know there's some people out there going, that sounds a little woo-woo, but it really is. We're all energy, and everything that we're thinking and feeling, and it is the intention, we can actually send that love, send those healing vibes, and shift it. And that's all it's all about, right? Making those small shifts, shifts in perspective, yeah, and shifts in our energy to make them. Thank you so much, Edith. Please catch her. If you go to her website, you can find her YouTube channel, her Instagram channel, her Facebook group where she does meditations and webinars. And I don't know, would you have something coming up for 11/11?
I just want to say that at YouTube, I have every Friday a new video coming out. It's like a 5 minutes video just explaining one of the chakras or one of the energy works. Is always a different explanation. Different theme. And then also on my webpage, I have the blogs, and then I'm also putting out new blogs every week and every week. So it's always updated, and you can have new information about this.
Yes, and she adds, there's a meditation on there that you can listen to. And again, all chock full of information. And I love that about you, just getting that word out and getting that energy out there for everyone to, you know, grab onto. So thank you so much, Edith, for being here and sharing all your gifts and energy. And everyone out there, encourage you, take a look. Get curious, okay? And, you know, do something new and different if you want something new and different, okay? And in the meantime, stay happy, healthy, positive. Enjoy the rest of your never-before-lived day. And take care. Bye.